Hey y'all, if you watched my last video, just know that this video will be a lot better than that one. I'm feeling a lot better today and Rumble is trying to get into my office right now because he thinks somebody's in there, but I'm the only one home. There's nobody in there. If you hear a lot of banging, just ignore it. This video will be a lot easier to film than my video from Friday, so I want to get into it. So I am back and I have more of your paranormal stories that I'm really scared to read today. We're gonna hop right into it. So this first story says, the little girl in my dreams. Hey Courtney, I just found your channel and have been binge watching your videos for days on end, for hours and hours. My name is Brooke and I go by they, them. I love hearing everyone's spooky experiences and hearing your reactions to them. I wanted to share my own from my old house. To start off, I lived in this house my entire life up until we moved out about 2 years ago. I'm 19 now for context. I had multiple experiences in this house as well as my entire family, but there was one that I would solely see. I never got her name, but I have a feeling she came from the multiple Ouija board games we played when I was younger. We thankfully no longer do that. We never had horrible experiences with it, but we as in my younger sister and friends, definitely may have let a couple spirits into our home. The little girl only ever seemed to appear in my room, and at that, when I was in a dreamlike state. Granted, we had many spirits in our house, somewhere around 4 or 5, with 1 or 2 on each floor, but my room seemed to be a hot spot, probably because I fed into their shenanigans and was willing to listen. Anyways, the first time I saw her was a few years ago at some ungodly hour of the night. I had a loft bed, and I would often wake up from my sleep and just sit up to stare at my window. I was conscious of what I was doing, but was never able to control it. One of the times I did this, though, the chair that usually sat by my window was gone, and in its place stood a little girl. She had a white dress on and looked like that girl from The Ring, but for some reason, I wasn't scared. I laid back down, going back to sleep. In the early morning hours of the same day, I had a dream of the same corner of my room, but of the ceiling. The little girl wasn't there, but her black hair grew down the wall and engulfed to the corner. Out of the two experiences alone, I didn't feel any dread or fear. I had no reaction at all. The following night, I had a dream. This I know was a dream of the same girl. I seemed to be in the living room with my mom and she just appeared, her white dress hanging around her ankles. Just as quickly as she appeared in the room, she flew at my mom, chasing her out the door. I heard her screech like one from those basic horror movies. As to why my mom would leave me with her, I have no clue, but she proceeded to sit next to me. She spoke in whispers I couldn't understand, but I knew she was trying to tell me something. Just like dreams are, I mysteriously started driving in the car with my mom, and the girl appeared in the front of the car, just like she did in the living room. Her eyes were glowing a bright white, I believe, and it seemed to be the only thing I could focus on, other than her whispers that she was doing once again. I woke up from the dream, not nearly as scared as you'd expect, but rather trying to figure out what she wanted. I never saw her again, but when we were moving out, I had this feeling she didn't want me to leave. She was the one entity in the house that my parents hadn't talked about, and I have a feeling she only ever was around me. As a side note, when we were in the process of moving, I would see dark shadows moving my peripheral vision. I had a feeling none of them were happy we were leaving. After we moved, I haven't felt her presence again, which makes me kind of sad, which probably sounds crazy. When I left, I felt like I was leaving her behind. I have this unnerving feeling I'll see her again though, but only time will tell. I have more stories from my old haunted-ass house if you want to hear more. I'd be more than happy to share. Also, sorry if this is everywhere. This house has given me more experiences than I can remember. I also uploaded another story. Okay, I didn't see that they uploaded another story, so I'll try to read that in my next video if I remember, because I already have stories picked out for this one, but we'll totally read their other story. That's crazy. Like, I feel like she came to you in a dream, so she really could communicate with you. But it's crazy because it's like you couldn't understand what she was saying. But I really do feel like she was trying to talk to you. She was trying to tell you something. And like, it's really, I don't know. I think I would feel the same way. When I left my mom's house, I felt guilty for leaving tea. But then stuff started happening at my apartment. And I don't know if it was her or not, but it was like almost comforting. It's like she was still there with me for some reason. Like she traveled with me all the way from Arizona to Texas. I don't know. And so I completely get that part. Like you feel bad leaving them. It's like you have some sort of connection with them. I don't know. I'm gonna stop talking about it. This next story says, the spirit in my house. First off, hi, my name is Victor. I've been subscribed since your, I can't say the word subscribed. Every time, I've tried to say that like 5 times now, and every time I say it, I mess up the rest of the sentence. I've been subscribed since your It Was More Than a School Shooting video, and I've loved you since. I'm non-binary, so please refer to me as they, them. I'm sorry this is so long, there's a lot. Also, I wanted to say this really quickly. I have a lot of people pointing out like smoke in my videos. You guys, I vape. So it like, I vape sometimes in between stories, or like if a story's really long, I'll take a break and I'll vape in between. I know it's a really bad addiction. And so if you see smoke or anything, it's totally my vape just like lingering. I usually try to wait like a minute after I hit it to start reading again, like to start talking, whatever. But if you see any smoke, it's probably from my vape. It's not like a ghost around me, I promise. I just wanted to clear that up because I have a lot of people commenting that. I don't really read my comments that often, just to avoid reading the mean ones. But whenever I do read them, I feel like I see someone saying something about smoke. It's my vape. I live in a relatively haunted house. I've lived here since my third birthday. I'm 15 while writing this, and I've been experiencing paranormal activity since I was around 7 or 8. The earliest one I can remember is when I was around 8 years old. I was laying on my bunk bed and I was trying to sleep because it was late and I was really tired. I was laying on my side and I could hear this light creaking noise behind me, along with a quiet tap. So as I was slash still am a very paranoid person, I rolled over. I could see my wardrobe door open. I now sleep with a band on my wardrobe so it won't open. This freaked me out because I'd never seen something like that happen. Another time on my bunk bed, I was sitting on it playing some game on my tablet and I felt something scratching at the wood underneath me. I leaned over the edge and looked under, but there was nothing there, but I had a weird feeling. Not quite like I was being watched, but like there was someone in the room. At some point in this room, it was really early in the morning. I didn't know what time, but I could feel it was in the morning. I felt something literally lifting up the side of my mattress. I was frozen in fear, and it was dead silent in the room. I just laid there, scared and trying to keep my breathing slow to make sure whatever it was would still think I'm asleep. Around 20-ish seconds later, I said in a sleepy voice, "Nina, it's not time to get up. Nina's my sister," and it immediately stopped. I didn't even hear my door shut. I bolted upright and nobody was in the room with me. I had this really creepy dream about this doll I had in this room at the time. I was on the floor near my door and I looked back at my doll, who was on the toy box opposite the door. Her eyes were rolled back and she was staring directly at me. She fell onto the floor and I screamed after I woke up. I looked at the floor and she had fallen over onto the floor. I don't know if they're linked, but I thought I'd add it. In my second room, after my sister Elizabeth moved out, I took her room. The activity wasn't that bad, but was still weird. At this point, I was around 10 or 11 years old. In my house, the bedroom doors have little window panels above them. I'll try and attach a picture. I don't think they attached a... Oh my god, I can't speak! I don't think they attached a picture, so... But I think I know what you mean. They're only about 10-ish centimeters tall, and I genuinely don't know why they're there, but whatever. One night, I was having a sleepover with my best friend at the time. Let's call her Emily. We were laying on my bed with our feet on the wall. We were gossiping and talking about school, and Emily said she saw something walk past the window. I was really confused and looked up at it. I didn't see anything, but I felt an uneasy feeling like I was being watched. We couldn't sleep very well that night. We just laid in my bed, too scared to step off of it. In this room, which my family calls the green room because the walls are green, I always hear really loud tapping in the walls. It didn't sound like it was coming from another room. It sounded like it was in the walls. It was always above me or near me. This always happened at night, and the tapping sped up and stopped right after. I still don't know what this is, and I've recently started hearing it again. I also used to see the curtains move without windows open or a fan on. My house is set up quite weirdly. You go up the stairs, and the bathroom is in the front of the stairs. My mom's room is next to the bathroom, then the green room, my sister's room, the one who still lived there, Nina, my first room, and a cupboard. If you walked out of the green room, you could sort of see down the stairs from a side point of view. I'll get to that later. During the summer, while I was still in the green room, my door was open and I was on the computer. I don't remember what I was doing, but I stood up to get a drink. I looked down the stairs before I walked to them and I saw some black figures speed down the stairs. It was really short and I only saw it for a second, but none of my family looks like that. I then, a few years later, moved into my current room, which is called the purple room in my family. You can guess it, the walls are purple. This was Nina's room. When I first moved into the purple room, stuff, which weren't heavy or bouncing on anything, fell over onto their side. I don't remember what fell, but it was kind of unnerving. This happened a few times. A while ago, I was having a sleepover with my cousin and I got up to use the toilet late at night. I finished using the toilet and got a weird feeling. For some stupid reason, I stopped walking and looked down the stairs. Bear in mind, my family were all in bed. I heard something like bare feet running on a smooth surface. My hallway, downstairs. I ran back into my room and we grabbed weapons, went downstairs and searched everywhere. You're brave. There was nothing. Me and her went back upstairs, blocked my door, and grabbed our weapons to protect ourselves if we had to. Nothing happened after that. More recently, I had a sleepover with my best friend, who I'll call Rin, since she watches your videos, I think, and she'd get pissed if she knew I wrote this part. We were about to go to sleep, so the lights were off. I rolled over to say something to her, and I could have sworn she was staring at me. Her eyes were black, and she was motionless, just looking at me. I asked her, "Rin, are you looking at me right now?" She replied, "No." Her mouth didn't move. I turned the light on and she was facing the other way, wrapped in a blanket. Oh my god. Another time, I was having a sleepover with Rin again. This was a few months ago. I was sleeping on the floor and she was on my bed because she didn't want to sleep on the floor. I was about to fall asleep when we heard two footsteps coming towards my door and then one big bang, like someone jumped right outside my door. Bear in mind, it was like 4 a.m. and my dog sleeps with my mom. I've also heard a dog or something running upstairs when my dogs were downstairs. Things like walking up and down the stairs when nobody's there, and I've seen shadows in the corner of my eye. It's no doubt in my mind that my house is haunted, and recently I've been hearing scratching in my attic even though we have rat repellent everywhere. And there's no possible way a human could be up there. If I have any updates, I'll send them here, and there's an update! They said, so more stuff has happened. I've been hearing a lot more stuff happen in my room lately, mainly noises coming from the walls. I still don't know what the noises are, but it's like a very light tapping. It's also felt like I was being watched again. This is getting more and more frequent. Yesterday, I was walking up the stairs when it sounded like something moving very quietly behind me. I turned around and saw one of the ceiling decorations we had hanging up for Christmas swinging violently. The other decorations weren't moving around it. They were completely still. A few nights ago, I was sitting in my bed. It was around 1 or 2 a.m., I think. I was watching some K-drama, and I could have sworn I saw something walk past the window above my door, which I've mentioned before. It was only for a split second, but I know what I saw. Last night is the last update I have for now, but it was so scary. To anyone else, this probably won't seem like a lot, but it was so scary at the time. Last night, around 2:43 a.m., I was watching K-drama again, and as it was so early, everyone was asleep. My father has some hearing issues, so he quite often has the TV on volume 12 to 14, but that will be important later. As some action happened in the drama, and screaming filled my ears, my TV was very quiet because I didn't want to wake anyone up, and I had headphones on. Sorry if that makes no sense. Oh, no, it makes sense. You're fine. I heard some talking outside of my room. It was really loud, so I could hear it even with my headphones on, so I took my headphones off. At first, I originally thought my uncle was watching something on his TV or my dad didn't turn his off properly, but that wasn't the case at all. The TV had turned on by itself downstairs. It was on the sports channel, too, and my dad hates sports. It took a good 10 minutes before I grabbed my multi-tool, which can turn into a knife, and went to turn it off. It was so loud. It was on volume 22. It was so hard to sleep after. I felt so terrified. I'm still a bit unnerved, and it's now 4:08 p.m. That's all I have for now. I almost feel like when it's all those little things that gather up and they get more and more frequent, I feel like that is just as scary as seeing a shadow so clearly in the corner of your room. Because it's almost like, I can't think of the word I'm trying to use, but it's like leading up to something bigger. Like it starts out with like really small shit and then it just happens more frequently and more frequently. And I feel like it's leading up to something. And that is terrifying. That's really scary. Do you still live at the house? I'm assuming you do because, oh, actually, yeah, because you just gave us an update. So I'm assuming you still live at the house. You have to keep us updated. If more stuff happens, you have to. This is the last story I'm gonna read. It's a little bit shorter because the first two were pretty long. This says, My Conjuring House. Hi Courtney, I'm Mia, and I have a story about my house and the weird-ass experiences that have happened here. Growing up, I've always had weird ghost stories from my old houses, but this house is the most active. We moved here in 2018, and ever since then, shit's gone down. The first experience for me was actually the first day we moved in. My mom asked me to stay home with my brother while she went out running errands for the new place. I've always been into ghost stories, movies, shows, etc. I was sitting on the couch, my baby brother was napping, he was maybe 2 at the time, that's important, while I was sitting on the couch, practically alone. The furthest door in the back of the house slammed shut, almost as if somebody had kicked it. I sat in pure shock and walked over to pick up my brother. I also kept hearing my name being called in a voice like my sister's. I ended up sitting on the couch until my mom came home. Around 3 months into living in the house, I got a call from my mom who was in a panic. Apparently someone had wrote, get out now, on the bathroom mirror after my mom took a shower. She was home alone. After these started happening, shit just got worse. I'm a medium. I sense things and I see things. I can communicate with them too. When I was in 7th grade, I woke up in the middle of the night. I turned around and there was a boy in my room. I thought it was my brother, but it wasn't. The boy's basic description was short, brown hair, and a white t-shirt. My brother is fairly tall, ginger, and was wearing a tie-dye shirt. The boy was gone in an instant, but I was scared shitless to say the least. I calmly walked upstairs in the fucking dark to my mom, praying I wasn't going to get possessed. My mom and I both have dreams of demons in our house, and we both swear we saw Satan in our dreams. It's horrific. Things will go missing, I wake up with random scratches and bruises, we see shadow people, and the worst part is the scratching on my door in the middle of the night. It bangs on my door, scratches, plays with the handle. It's terrifying. That's all for now. Sorry, it's kind of shitty. I will update. Love you. It's not shitty at all. It's not. I don't think I'd ever be able to sleep with my door closed if there was some sort of entity playing with my door. I feel like, but then if you have your door open, there's like the chance that something walks past or walks in. So I don't know which one. I don't know which one is worse. I really don't know. That is all I have for now. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you have any stories that you want to share with me or the community, I will have my subreddit linked down below. This video was definitely a lot easier to film. No tears in this video. No tears. This video was a lot easier to film because it was an actual distraction. I told myself I was going to upload this week so I could be distracted in some sort of way. And if you don't know what I'm talking about, watch my last video, unless you don't give a shit, then who cares? But I told myself I wanted to be distracted. This was an actual distraction. This was. Last video, no, because I'm talking about it. But this felt good. This felt very good. I'm gonna upload next week too, or I should upload next week. My friend is coming into town. Oh my God. My friend is coming into town, so I'm not sure what next week will look like. We'll see. We'll just see when we get there. But I hope you guys enjoyed. I love y'all. I will see you in the next one. Bye. Also, look how cute. Okay, so I got this like set. I don't really want to stand up because I'm insecure about my body. We're not gonna show anything down here. I got this set. It's like super fuzzy. I got it from Amazon. I don't know what I looked up. I think I just looked up like loungewear sets for women. Like, I don't know. But it's like super fuzzy and it's really comfy. I really like it. I've been going ham lately. Do people say that anymore? Going ham? Like, is that, am I just old? I've been going crazy shopping lately because I am sad. So I've been buying a lot of stuff. I made a TikTok haul if you're interested. I spent like way too much money the other day at Target and Marshall's. Way too much money. And then I bought this on Amazon. And I need to stop buying things on Amazon. I need to deactivate my Amazon, but I'm gonna go. See ya.